Welcome, bienvenue, welcome. Fremda, étranger, stranger. Glücklich zu sehen, je suis enchanté. Happy to see you, bleib, rest, stay.
It's so tough. For me, I'm playing the character that is essentially handpicking these people throughout the show by being at the cabaret and playing this double character, double-sidedness. And it's a very emotional feeling. Just knowing that if I had lived in that time, I would have been there.
Members that we have on our concentration camp uniforms are actual real numbers of people that were disabled. These are real people, these are real stories, these are real human beings that had, you know, it's eerie.
The T4 program, which was what they used on the disabled, if you were blind, if you had any invisible disability, they carted you off. What they first started doing is they started taking them to the hospitals, and they drug them, and they wouldn't feed them, and they basically starved people to death. Well, they felt that that didn't go fast enough, so they started using drugs, and they felt that that was too expensive. So that's when they started making vans. They basically put the exhaust into the back of the sealed van and drove around until people asphyxiated. And that's where they came up with the idea for the gas chambers. And I don't mean to draw a parallel between modern society and the T4 program, but a lot of people nowadays look at people with disabilities as people who just suck off the system. That always makes me think about the T4 program and how the thought process that it turned into, this horrific humanitarian disaster.
The end of Act One is really a chilling thing to do when, because you see kind of the slide towards the power of the Nazi Party over the course of the first act. The way, you know, it's directed, just more and more people start coming in, and you see people on stage, people with disabilities even, faced with making that choice of, okay, here's this angry mob that's coming in and hailing Hitler. But there are some of our actors with visible disabilities who are on the fringe who are hailing also, because it really just comments on the nature of survival and preservation, and some people are willing to instantly put their foot down and say, no, this is wrong, and some people will go along with something until they end up, you know, being targeted by it. The show is really interesting in how it presents those moral dilemmas. None of the main characters really do the right thing for the right reason in the end, I would say. None of them are bad, and none of them are vilified for it, but none of them are really celebrated either. They're just, these are the people, and this is what happened, and some of them lived, and some of them died.
Adolf Hitler had Parkinson's. I've always said I wouldn't wish the symptoms on my worst enemy, but wishing them on Adolf Hitler is a pleasure.